Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest is a rising star who has appeared in FX Network's Atlanta, the recent Superfly movie, and has now landed a role in the Fox hit series Star. Let's take a look.
You know you owe me everything, right? You forget I'm the one that named you Cotton in the first place.
You better get the hell out of here.
I'm gonna pay you back for this. Trust.
Woo, please welcome to the show actor, musician, and my hometown brother from the uptown, Kearshine.
Hey, you did.
What's going on? All right. Hey.
What's up? Absolutely. Put your Stunner frames on.
Off the roof.
How you doing, Kim?
Hey.
Come on, it's such
a pleasure to be able to be here with you guys this morning.
Yes, absolutely, it's good to have you.
What's up, Buttercup?
Oh man, blessed by the best.
I know, blessed by the best.
You know, the thing about it is, as far as art imitates life, and you know, my story is the only one I want to tell. So I want to be able to draw from the experiences of our hometown,
M-Town,
and be able to just be creative and create. You know what I mean? So I'm thankful that Star gave me the canvas to be able to draw from that inspiration as an artist. You did.
Well, you've been creative and great for a long time. We're talking about all the way back in 2007, Billboard chart topper, Crispy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you've just been doing your daggone thing for a while. So, like, do you feel you're finally getting your just due?
I believe that, you know, at the end of the day, man, I'm just thankful. You know, I'm humble. So I won't crumble, and in life you don't fumble. So at the end of the day,
this is the M-Town right here.
At the end of the day, you know, I don't do it for applause. I do it for purpose.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, I think that I'm thankful I'm not where I was.
Yeah.
But I'm not yet where I want to be.
Yeah,
I got more work to do.
Well, you're doing it big.
You know.
I mean, listen, you got a BMI award
for
co-writing the song with Drake, right?
Yeah, the best I ever had record.
The best I ever had. How did that come about?
The best I ever had record came from a record that I originally produced for Lil Wayne called Do It For The Boy, and Drake actually sampled it and took some of the parts, the hook and stuff like that, and was able to make it a four-time platinum single now. So it was just a blessing to being able to have the session with Wayne, and shout out to Drake. He's continuing to do his thing. But you know, it's weird that God always uses me to be in the beginning of people's career, because you know, you talk about Drake, but Yo Gotti was another one too.
That
you know, you from the town, so you know the Life album, and able to work with him was also really cool. So I'm just thankful, man, to be able to be used. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So you jump behind the scenes, because you had a great music career too. Come on now.
The thing about it is this, you know, I think that there are seasons. And there are certain seasons where God uses me in front of the camera, and there's certain seasons where he put me behind the camera.
Absolutely.
At the end of the day, you know, I got these notes and throats. You dig what I'm saying? I got these kids. So guess what? You know, whatever season he got me at, that's what I need to be doing. So, you know, but I think in life, you know, and especially as an artist, and someone maybe watching is like, the transition, you know, you can't get caught up in what the universe or God bless you with last season, thinking this is how it's gonna happen for you this season.
Exactly.
It don't necessarily go that way. You know, in music, I had my deal with Universal, so Crispy, and I had a dope album that I think was dope, but it's like, you know, I still am a musician at heart, and I still make music, create music, but I'm like, if there's an opportunity for me to be able to feed my family for writing for this individual or be able to do something else, then I'm not gonna turn that down.
Absolutely.
You know,
not.
So at the end of the day, you know, I just gotta go to where the blessing is at. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, like earlier in the show, Selena, she lit it up blue for your son.
Oh man, you almost made me cry with that one. I was back there trying not to cry, but man, that was a touching, very. I really appreciate you guys for doing that.
Yeah.
But tell us about the documentary you have, Jameson's Journey.
Yeah, Jameson's Journey. With this being April and Autism Awareness Month, I wanted to at least take this month to be able to make people aware and put a face, an urban face, with autism. Because I mean, and shout out to Celine, because I know she has a son with autism as well. And it's like I just don't see enough of us really explaining and explaining how it goes. You know, being an autism, a parent with a child with autism is serious, you know what I mean? It's a puzzle. So at the end of the day, I just wanted to create a documentary that allowed people to be able to see what it is like to be able to parent a child with autism, and then understand too, as far as the medical side of it, there are a lot of holes that we, I mean, a lot of stumbling blocks in the way of us medicating, you know what I mean, and doing that as well. So there's a lot of things that we got to do to be able to create the awareness. So we're just doing the documentary and we're showing, giving a voice to kids without one, you know what
yeah.
I mean?
Yeah, you know? Well, I'm proud of you. Come on, yeah. Memphis.
You know, indeed,
really,
man.
Really quickly, let's talk a little bit about Leon and your role on Star. What can we expect? What can we expect this season?
Okay, Leon is definitely, definitely a man about the streets, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? And he has a way with words and, uh-huh. And a way with the women. But at the end of the day, I don't want to do a spoiler alert of what's going to happen, but
all
I
right.
will tell you that you need to definitely keep watching. Leon's definitely up to some crookedness, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? And he's definitely, you know, definitely a little bit skeety.
We definitely saw that, but you know.
But it's cool to play something that, you know, that I'm, if you follow me with Coffee with Kim Forgive It, that you know that I'm like not into that vibe, but I'm from Memphis, and you know, so I can pull from it.
And we're gonna watch you do that. So we thank you for coming and sharing your story with us. And guess what? Be sure to catch Kia Shine in Star Wednesdays on Fox.